The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom should I dread? When those who do evil draw near, they stumble and fall. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom should I dread? When those who do evil draw near, they stumble and fall. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Ahab sent to all the children of Israel and had the prophets assemble on Mount Carmel. Elijah appealed to all the people and said, "How long will you strive on this issue? If the Lord is God, follow him. If Baal, follow him." The people, however, did not answer him. So Elijah said to the people, "I am the only serving prophet of the Lord, and there are 450 prophets of Baal. Give us two young bulls. Let them choose one, cut it into pieces, and place it on the wood, but start no fire. I shall prepare the other and place it on the wood, but shall start no fire. You shall call on your gods, and I will call on the Lord. The God who answers with fire is God." All the people answered, "Agreed." Elijah then said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose one young bull and prepare it first, for there are more of you. Call upon your gods, but do not start the fire." Taking the young bull that was turned over to them, they prepared it and called on Baal from morning till noon, saying, "Answer us, Baal." But there was no sound, and no one answered. And they hopped around the altar they had prepared. When it was noon, Elijah taunted them, "Call out, for he is a god and may be meditating, or may have retired, or may be on a journey. Perhaps he is asleep and must be awakened." They called out louder and slashed themselves with swords and spears, as was their custom, until blood gushed over them. Noon passed, and they remained in a prophetic state upon the time for offering sacrifice. But there was not a sound. No one answered, and no one was listening. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come here to me." When the people had done so, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been destroyed. He took 12 stones from the number of tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the Lord had said, "Your name shall be Israel." He built an altar in honor of the Lord with stones, and made a trench around the altar large enough for 2 measures of grain. When he had arranged the wood, he cut up the young bull and laid it on the wood. Fill four jars with water, he said, and pour it over the burnt offering and over the wood. Do it again, he said. They did it again. Do it a third time, he said, and they did it a third time. The water flowed around the altar, and the trench was filled with water. At the end of the offering sacrifice, the prophet Elijah came forward and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and have done all things by your commandment. Answer me, Lord. Answer me that this people may know that you, Lord, are God, and that you have brought them back to their senses. The Lord's fire came down and consumed the burnt offering, wood, stones, and dust, and it lapped up the water in the trench. Seeing this, all the people fell prostrate and said, The Lord is God. The Lord is God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep me safe, O God. You are my hope.
Keep me safe, O God. You are my hope.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, My Lord are you.
Keep me safe, O God.
They multiplied their sorrows, who court other gods. Blood libations to them I will not pour out, nor will I take their names upon my lips.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
O Lord, my allotted portion and cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. I set the Lord ever before me, and with him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed.
Keep me safe, O God.
You will show me the path to life, fullness of joy in your presence, the delight at your right hand forever.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
The God who answers with fire is God. The God who answers with fire is God. So we have the story of Elijah and the prophets of Baal on Mount Carmel from 1 Kings 18. The prophets of the false God have to do so much to try to get themselves into the right frenzy, the right emotional state, in order to move their false God to act and manifest himself. His manifestation seems so built on their frenzy. Elijah, on the other hand, waters down the sacrifice so that it's really clear that it's not about him and what he does, it really is about God and God's moving. So the manifestation of God, the true God, does not first require Elijah to go into some emotional frenzy to bring about God's action. And sure enough, the true God answers with fire. Apply that to our life spiritually. The God who answers with fire is God. Knowing that the Lord is God doesn't first require an emotional frenzy on our behalf, but knowing him as the one true God certainly involves fire. A fire that he sends down from heaven to us. Remember John the Baptist pointing to Jesus, saying that he is the one who will baptize with water and with fire. In our scene on Mount Carmel today, it's pretty amazing that water gets set on fire. Water gets set on fire. The Book of Wisdom actually talks about that God is so amazing, he sets water on fire. Well, that's exactly what Jesus does when he baptizes us. We're baptized with water that's on fire with the Holy Spirit. And forever throughout life, for the baptized soul, our relationship with God involves fire sent from heaven. Catholics are supposed to be on fire for God, on fire with the Holy Spirit, on fire with divine love. Receiving the fiery Eucharist can certainly keep our hearts aflame throughout life.
For the church,
may the Lord preserve and protect her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of the word, may the Lord nourish in them virtues of selfless service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from war, oppression, or in any sin against justice and humanity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here, may we be sanctified by the sacrament we receive and have grace to preserve in faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may perpetual light shine upon them and may they rest in eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, we thank you for hearing our petitions. We ask that you use these prayers joined to the Sacred Heart of your Son in this Eucharist to accomplish your glory. All this we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you and lead us to grow in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory,
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord,
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed
By divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God,
behold him who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Communion Antiphon.
The Lord is my rock, my fortress and my deliverer. My God is my saving strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress and my deliverer. My God is my saving strength.
Thank you.
body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Spiritual communion prayer for those who are physically present. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to what is right. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.